Between the two of you, husband and wife, you just try to do it as a wife. Just comment on another husband and you say, hey, he was looking good. He was, and then you realize that your husband is suffering from that low self-esteem. What he would do to make himself relevant, he would try to criticize the same person. My wife, what are you talking about? Those suits are the cheapest that you can get in town. Even you as a husband, try to comment it. That one will be even much serious. She might not even respond. Low self-esteem. This is the main reason why, if you look at most of the housemaids, how beautiful they are. You can tell that the mother of the house is not comfortable. You wonder, where do they get these people from? You try it. You drive around. Just go there and see. If a young and beautiful looking girl comes looking for a job, it doesn't matter how good she can perform, as long as she's beautiful, I can guarantee you, she's never going to get that job. That beauty is the disqualification. As long as you are beautiful like that. Why? Because you are coming there to make the mother of the house uncomfortable. Low self-esteem. Even if she's going to be kept there, she's always going to be criticized. She's always going to be criticized. No matter what she does, she's still going to be criticized by the mother of the house. I'm even thinking of getting another one. This one is useless. If you ever come close to her, I don't know. I wonder whether she really takes a bath or maybe she will be, so that she'll begin to develop hatred towards her. The next time you look at her, you can actually smell from afar. You can smell her from afar, and yet she's never done anything wrong. Critics. It's coming from a married woman who is not comfortable, who is suffering from low self-esteem. Any other person that comes close to her, she will criticize. So you see, it's easy to become one, right? Very easy to become a critic. Very easy. All of us, we have once criticized somebody to make ourselves relevant. I think I've said something very strong there. And some of you here, you have got even sisters that you have, you'd rather keep her somewhere. Trying to get rid of any competition around your husband. People that you should be looking after, you can't have them close to you because you can't handle the pressure and the competition. You are not confident of yourself. You are not confident at all. You are not confident. Why should you be threatened in your own country, in your own area? You are a citizen. Whoever comes into that place is a foreigner. You are an expert. You know every highway and byway and avenue. Be comfortable. Be comfortable. Low self-esteem can produce a critic. Number six. unproductivity. Unproductivity. If a person is not productive, the rate of criticism also goes high in an economy where unemployment rate is very high. If industries are closing down, there has to be another industry that should be opened. Because still people, they are used to work. And if there is nothing else to do, they will talk. Because you are designed by God to function and to work and to produce. But if there is nothing to produce, you still have to produce something. Hello? Unproductivity. If people are not productive, they are bound to criticize. You are criticized for doing nothing and you are criticized for doing something. You have to know that. If you don't do anything, you are criticized. If you do something, you are criticized. Because also doing nothing is actually doing. Well, the moment you start doing something, you are no longer doing nothing. To be doing nothing, you have to do nothing. So you're doing something by doing nothing. You still have to be doing something in life. There is an edge to do something. So if a person is not productive, if a person is not productive, like they say, an idle mind is the devil's workshop. There is a man that wanted a certain job to be performed and he couldn't find workers. And he went to the marketplace in the word of God and he found some other men there standing in the marketplace. And he said, these ones I can use, these ones. How can people stand in such a place where money is flowing everywhere and they're just standing like that? And he said, you guys, I need to find a job for you. Because nobody is allowed just to be standing like you're standing there. Come and work. And he got a job for them. So every time when the devil comes into your nation and he finds you standing and nothing is happening, he makes you work in his field. There has to be production. If I tell you something here, you'll be shocked. Personally, I've never, even once, been criticized by anybody who is doing what I'm doing better. As in, I've never. I've never. Listen, please don't misquote me. I never said I'm the only person doing the best. There are so many other people that are doing much better than what I'm doing, but I'm saying I've never been criticized by such people. I've looked at everybody that have criticized me. Is not even doing half of what I'm doing. Hello? Hello? The people, they are there, I'm not the best. There are people that are doing better than what I'm doing, but I'm saying I've never heard them. They might have spoken into my life and given me constructive criticism. I will talk about that at the end. Not destructive. I've never been criticized in a negative way by people that are doing what I'm doing in a much better way. I've never, not even one. Not even one, not even one. So you can understand now where criticism has to be coming from a lower point of view. People are supposed to be productive. If they are not productive, they will still produce something. Number 7. I still have 7 more to go, but let's stop at number 7. Jealousy. I don't think I should even explain that one, right? Can you all agree that maybe that could be another cause for critics? Yeah, this is the other reason why critics can begin to criticize. It will be because of maybe jealousy, envy, and a lot of things, and people can criticize. People can criticize. I don't know why, you know, even I look at my life, like I said, when we were growing up in the things of God, I don't remember. I normally used to like and to love good things. Even if it means it has to be somebody driving that nice car, I would appreciate it. I would move around, talk about it. I've seen Mr. So-and-so driving a very beautiful car. But in a place where people are jealousy, anybody that drives a good car, he has stolen money from somewhere. Jealousy. Jealousy. Do you know that even the president of this country, if he was going to consult people, he would be in a combi right now? The president of this nation, if he really wanted to listen to the people, he would be driving a minibus right now. They criticize him even for the car that he drives. It consumes a lot of fuel. Caring who? Caring who? If it consumes a lot of fuel, is your fuel missing? If you left a container somewhere and you can't find it, what's your problem? That's jealousy. The same person vote him into power, he would want to get into the same car that consumes fuel. Because now he's inside. When he's not part of what is happening, he attacks it. The moment he gets in, my God. So even if you find anybody that you think might be criticizing me, maybe he doesn't understand me, you just tell me, Mr. So-and-so is criticizing you. And then I will go there and then I will say, I've come to submit. I'm now your son from today. You, the same person. Listen to the next sermon. We are in good books from that moment. Because he is now inside the same vehicle. He doesn't want the vehicle to consume fuel when he's outside. The moment he gets inside. We shouldn't be jealous as leaders. We shouldn't be jealous. So let's go to part B. I gave you part A. Part A, what produce a critic? That's what I've been talking about. Number one, we said, what is it? Bad experiences. And number two, disappointments. Number three, shattered dreams and visions. Number four, defensive attitude. Number five, low self-esteem. Number six, unproductivity. And the last one for today, jealousy. And part B, let me show you something. I'd want you to write something on part B. Criticism was meant for the critic. Criticism is a misdirected gift. I'm just trying to look at it from a good point of view. Let's try to get something good out of it. Criticism, since a lot of people possess it, it's a gift, right? But it is a misdirected gift.
Thank you for watching Minister's Material. Join us again next time for yet another inspirational teaching from Prophet Emmanuel Makandiwa.